Hi, everybody.
I had the worst weekend. Oh, the worst. Absolutely the worst. Just. I really was like, I'm tired. So I just was like, I'm just going to cruise this weekend. And even though I'd Skyped with Danny several times, he didn't mention anything about coming. So he calls me on Friday and says, I'll be there at so-and-so, and we were invited over to this cocktail party, and I like just went, no, sorry, you're crooked. Here, let me move you around. I went, no. He went, what? It's like, no, I don't want to go. And he said, well, why not? And I said, well, one, you've had all week to tell me about this. Did you just find out about this today? And he said, no. It's like, could you have told me about it? You know, it's like, well, it was no problem. She'll just want to go. But I didn't want to go. I didn't want to do anything. I had not heard that even he was coming to town. So it was like, cool. Yeah, I'll do my thing this weekend. Plus, yeah, my brain was like hiccuping, but it's kind of like one of those things like, did my incident with Danny cause my brain to go a little hiccupy, or was my brain already hiccupy? It's kind of like which came first, the chicken or the egg. So anyway, he goes, and I said, plus my cocktail dresses are at the cleaners and I don't feel like going and get. He goes, I'll get them. I said, no, I don't want to go. He's like, well, I'll come over afterwards. I said, no. He said, don't you want to see me? I said, no. And, you know, and I didn't mean to make that sound mean, but it was like, no. I just am tired. I just want to do my own thing this weekend, which is basically nothing. And it was just like, oh, don't you want to see me? It's like, no, I don't. Thank you, but no. So, yeah. Finally, yeah. But he did, I mean, we Skype sometimes every day. He tells me what's going on politically and, you know, what's happening in each state, not, you know, and plus we talk. So Saturday I decided to go shopping. So I went to Ross and I bought this. This is so funny why I bought this. It's, oh God, it's hard to read. Adrian V.I. Vittatini. Vittadini, and it says studio, and it says daytime nude palette, and it was for $4.99, and I bought it because there was only one of them sealed, so I bought it kind of like as a mystery bag. So let's see if we can get it open. I couldn't find scissors anywhere. I know they're here somewhere, so if I write on it, well, so be it. I couldn't find anything else. Oh, I could have gotten a knife. So let's see what it looks like. Let's see what it says. Now that the glare is off it. Five of Swords Shadows. Now see, this isn't a reasonable amount of stuff to put in something. It has talc, magnesium, cerate, paraffin liquid, polybutane. Okay, maybe it's kind of weird stuff, and then a coloring. And it has an eyeliner pencil. So let's open it up and look. Oh, look, it's got a nice little band. Wow, they're kind of weird colors. This is called the daytime shade look. You know. I mean, these are like. Oh, that looks nice. It looks gold. Let's see. This one looks orange. No, it's not. Let's see what the brown looks like. The contour. Doesn't look too bad. See, I can't swatch. It has a little eyeliner pencil. And a little teeny brush. Look, little teeny tiny. Like, I can't hold on to that. Plus, I don't like the spongy things. I like brushes. I only own, like, an actual, you know, makeup brush that you use to put on makeup. A powder brush. And I think two or three eyeshadow brushes. But it says, you know, it tells you how to do it, the steps, for people like me. So, I just bought it, because I didn't know what was in it. Hey, it was a weird week. And then I bought some spa subscription masks. Is there an English part? Oh, there it is. Brightening spa treatment mask with vitamin C and chialonic acid, however you say that. Glow, illuminate, and radiate. 20-minute facial scrub mask. You know, it's the paper ones. I've enjoyed every one I've ever bought. I mean, I buy a, you know, whole different one. And this was $4.99. And then I got real nostalgic. I don't know if it was like all this. Sorry about my nose, but things are blooming. I got real nostalgic. And I was buying something. Oh, I think it's when I went to get the medicine I didn't think I had. I thought I'd filled this drug. And so, have you ever done a manic search where you couldn't stop yourself? And it's like, well, maybe it fell out in the trunk, because sometimes I'll come out of the drugstore and just throw them, you know, all in the trunk. I searched the trunk. I have a drug drawer that I keep all the drugs in. You know, I started that when the grandkids were little, and I just still do it. That way, if I, you know, get drugs filled ahead of time, because I get 90 days at a time. I just open the drawer and empty out everything. And so I bought this, which I'm not crazy about Vaseline lip therapy, but it's rosy lips. I got real nostalgic for rose balm. And it smells okay. I was a little disappointed. I think it's a little tinted. That's what it looks like. When I was young, that's why I keep saying I got nostalgic. My grandmother would make rose, she would, you know, tincture rose petals. And she would make, oh God, all sorts of stuff. She loved the smell of roses. So she had like rose water that she would make, you know, as a perfume or a cologne. I mean, I just, when you think back, all I can, you know, when I think back and I think of my grandmother, it's all just roses. And she made some soap out of, and they would have rose petals in them. They were so cool looking. And she would make rose balm. I prefer the Dior rose balm, but it's like $28 or more. I think the last time I bought it, it was like, I got it at Macy's, and it was way cheaper than even off any place you could buy it. But I'd rather have the Dior, but, and this is only okay. I saw one at the Vitamin Cottage, so I may pick it up, but I just got nostalgic for rose lip balm. It's one of my favorite lip balms. I need a cup of coffee. And I also bought this dress, and it's really cool because it's like cut at an angle, and each side of it, I guess if you get the right side, there is a pocket at the sharp edge. And it's like, I guess either a long, because see it's pointy, so it's like a long shirt. It's just a jersey, and it says $68, but I paid $7.49 at Ross. And what I, why I got it was, I have a couple capri leggings, but I'm not into the Lululemon. So this is like, would be a very short skirt for a dress for me, or a long top. And then I bought these, I don't know. They're called, that. And they were $9.99. And they might actually be leather, but I don't think so. But I love me bling. And I'll wear them with something like this for like a picnic. Because picnics here, I'm going to sound like the New York housewives. Hold on. Picnics here are like either like, you know, anything you're wearing, or I tend to wear like summer dresses to them with, you know, like a nice pair of flip-flops. A lot of them are not casual. I don't know why. But, so, so to figure out about my drug, I don't know if I finished that one. I finally decided, stop. I don't know if you guys have ever gone through that where you just keep looking and looking and looking and you can't stop yourself. It's like, do you have no self-control? It's like, no. And so I finally decided, I'd call the pharmacy. This would be a good way to solve this problem. So I called them and they said, no, but we can refill it for you. And it's like, oh, okay. And they go, you know, the pharmacist knows me. And he goes, well, you sound kind of weird over this. I said, I just totally went through my whole house looking for this. And it hasn't been filled. I could have swore I refilled it. I got a refill for it because I'm on an automatic refill, like I said, for 90 days. And he said, why didn't you just call me first? And it's like, that would have been too simple. But anyway, so I'm not, I didn't talk to Danny at all. I don't want to. I'm sure I'll get over it. It's just, yeah, I felt like, well, I don't need to tell her ahead of time. You know, and if we didn't Skype 3 times or more a week, that would be a different thing. But, you know, it's like he could have said, hey, by the way, I'm coming to town. It's like, I just, well, plus, to be honest, because I'd heard nothing from him, it was perfectly fine with me. Because I really did not want to do anything. Oh, I found something. I got to show this to you. This is hilarious because Denny's saying, why don't you wear your ear crawler? And you know, I'd like to wear them. But look, I found almost, I mean, he'll think they're the same, that I'm wearing my actual ear crawler. I got it at World Market. That's exactly almost what they look like. The diamonds aren't this same cut, but he'll never know. So this was, so I have a dupe for my own ear jewelry. It was $9.99 half price. It's made in India. But I thought, I'll wear him to go to a picnic now. If it'll make him feel better. He'll never know. I'm not going to say that I bought a dupe. But he's not lying. I'll just put him on and he'll say, oh, those look so nice. Because that's almost, they're exactly, I got that many stones in the real one. And then a diamond maybe a little bigger than that. But I couldn't believe it. For half of $9.99, I'll wear them all the time. Maybe I'll put them on and show them to you. Because I really think the ear crawlers are absolutely cool. I think they're one of the best things they've invented lately. So anyway, I didn't see Danny all weekend. He was here. He has his own place. He's a big boy. He can live. Just was not a great weekend for me. It wasn't like it was bad, but I stopped answering the phone because apparently everybody else was having a bad weekend. And it was just getting me on tilt. It really was. But like I said, I have some neurological problems that every now and then they kick up. And I myself have no problems dealing with them. Look at this. This is weird. My necklace is sticking out of the hole. I find this blouse interesting because it's got this hole. Kind of, now if you pull it down, it's a little sexy. So the weather is warming up, and then it's supposed to rainy and warm up, rainy, warm up, rainy, warm up. So I don't know what we're doing. So basically, my weekend just consists of just hanging. I had a good time. I wrote some letters. Watched lots of TV. House Rules is now on in Australia. I'm telling you, if you can get Australian TV, you should watch it. Because the Housewives of Melbourne are really funny. They have even a psychic among them. And it's really interesting. But, you know, I'm a junkie. I mean, I seriously am. I'm watching Dallas, New York, The End. I'm waiting for the last reunion for the Beverly Hills. Because they have two and there's one more. And Melbourne. And then the one that's from England, Chelsea. They're kind of different there. But anyway, I need to go unload my dishwasher. Loaded. I have no groceries. And I don't care. I think I have like a turkey pot pie and my burritos. You know, I have lots of burritos. So, I mean, I can live till tomorrow. I'm not going to go shopping till tomorrow. But I am enjoying this. But I don't normally like Vaseline products. I wonder what they say is in it. Like, I have no idea if they're animal cruelty-free or anything. It says just petroleum flavor, aroma, with the color red. So it's even fake. That's why I like the Dior. If you've not, it comes, you know, I love the Dior lip balm. It just sits, I mean, you can have, and they have one now with a lip plumper that works pretty good, they say. I myself would not buy it. I mean, big lips is getting to be... Because, you know, every time my daughter comes over, her lips are either bigger or little. she's setting an appointment for me. I'm having dermabrasion done to my whole face. She owns the machine that does it. She just has to order some needles. And I guess I'm getting my whole face done. And she said it will get rid of a lot of the fine lines. So I will definitely take you on that with me. I said, well, what am I going to look like when I walk out? And she says, you'll pretty much look normal. So, you know, I don't know. But she's talked me into it. Still no Botox and still no Dermafill. I'm not interested. I'm happy with things the way they are. because I didn't think I could do Botox, but I talked to my neurologist, and he said, well, yeah, I don't know why you'd want to, but he said, no, it will not bother you. And so, you know, I have an okay on it if I want to have Botox, but I know I should take advantage of this because it's all free, you know, because she gets so much Dermafill and Botox for as much as she uses. The company gives her free tubes of Dermafill, the Juvederm, and Botox. So, you know, it doesn't cost her anything. But last time she came over, her lips were like, whoa. But, you know, they calm down. But so anyway, that's basically, you know, what this vlog is about, my bad weekend. I guess, you know, and it, you know, again, you know, mentally I'm fine, except I did get mad, I think. But it was like, yeah, I'm not gonna harp on it anymore. What he said is what I said. So, let's see. So I think that's all the stuff. I know I bought more because I kind of, on Sunday, I felt really relaxed and happy. So I kind of like wandered around, shopped a little here, shopped a little there. Looked for a new phone case, but I couldn't find one that I liked. I mean, I think it's going to have to be an Amazon purchase because I have a Samsung. So it's not like, because when you go to the store, if, you know, they have this plethora of phone cases, but they're all for iPhones. And I have a Samsung. And if I could choose between an iPhone and a Samsung, I'd still choose the Samsung. I'm a Samsung freak. Well, I bit on the phone. Oh, I got my living room. I got my kitchen. It's because I need to vacuum. And I need to mop, but I need to go grocery shopping. I'm doing that tomorrow. Oh, I forgot. And I went everywhere. Somehow it got tangled in my glasses. Look at this cool shirt I got for $1. Isn't it cool? It's just like a little... See, I love muted colors. I love greens like this. I love all the muted colors. But I think I paid 95 cents for it. That's what I paid. I found a new secondhand store. And it's just a few blocks from my house. It's like, I'm going to be going there all the time. Oh, and I just heard back, for those of you that don't know, the guy that I was originally going to have installed the swamp cooler has to have hernia surgery. So I went and asked one of my friends who she uses. And when she told me the guy, I mean, we all know the guy, but I did not know because he's from Argentina and he has a degree in civil engineering. But basically does handyman, and then he gets some work. But his, apparently, a lot of countries, their degrees don't transfer very well. So when I called him, he said that he came right over and looked at it. And he can rebuild it, and it's just going to be over $200. It's like yesterday, I was in such shock over it. I'd done some Snapchats. Again, that's being Claudee. If you want to talk to me, feel free. I mean, I think it's just open to the public. I don't think you even have to get approval from me. So I'm going to go out and eat dinner. And like, I'm still in shock because I had moved money around to, you know, make sure that I had available enough money to buy the swamp cooler to install it. And I'm like he said, he had to go to this other city to get the parts, so he's charging me $25, and it's like, dude, go for it. I don't care. Please, go. So that's about it for me today, because I'm going to go out and eat. And so I need to kind of wash up. We're going to go to this new, I guess it's Tibetan. So we're going to go to this, at least new to us. It's not new. I think it's been open, I don't know, maybe 8 months, maybe close to a year. But I've never gone there. So we're going to go there. I'm assuming it's like Indian food. Because the one Tibetan restaurant I've eaten at here was like Indian food. So, but I love you guys. And now, I just love it when I see, you know, people subscribe to me. I really do. Please subscribe if you haven't. Thumbs up. I love to do that. Thumbs up. I better go. I gotta get ready. Bye-bye.